Today, we are going to be playing Black Hole.
No one escapes the black hole.
No one escapes the black hole, apparently. Oh, I must have seen history already. Okay. Oh, wait. Oh, I did, because this is one of the ones where I played during the charity stream. Right. I remember this. This was a good table. But I haven't played it on a pinball night yet. So. Oh. Aww. I don't like that. That's like the thing I don't like about this table. It automatically kills you if you don't do well enough in that little center thing. Kinda sucks. Oh, here we go. I have no idea how you're supposed to get the re-entry there. I think just do well enough? Or what? I don't know. Oh, you can't switch the bonus things up there with the flippers. That sucks. I have less control over this board than I thought. Oh, I forgot to see what my high score was. Oh, well. Pay more attention this time. Oh, no! Oh. Oh, no, it's not. Okay. Failed. Oh no! So, not surprising anyone. I've been thinking about a lot about Dark Souls lately. Because I beat it yesterday, and, I don't know what. Okay. Well, so I've been thinking about it a lot lately, and man, do those games just love kicking you in the balls and making you feel completely. I think it's another low scoring table, yeah, unfortunately. I'm not sure when this thing was made because you'd only get the history thing once, and I played this during the charity stream. I thought I liked it back during the charity stream, but it turns out kind of BS. Because, like, I don't know, but yeah, like that, exactly. I could have tilted that. To be fair, that was perfect. That was completely my fault. I saw it coming a mile away, and I did jack shit to attempt to save it. I think most of the points come from this middle part here. You want to spend as much time in it as possible. that's your bonus, and I think you can get that multiplied, but multiplying it's hard because you can't control which lights up at the top go where. They're just completely static, unfortunately. Yeah, see, you can't control if you get the first, second, or third. But oh no, I tilted the wrong way. Ah, well, it's my best score of the night so far, including the one I didn't write down. Like 8. It was like half that. I have a vacation coming up, around, actually by this time next month, I was not paying attention. That was completely my fault, because I looked at my watch instead of keeping my eye on the ball. It's gonna be less than a month from now. I'm taking a vacation. I think even on major stream days, because I won't have too much going on in the day, I'll probably end up doing a pinball night every night. Just 7 fucking straight nights of pinball for an hour, no matter if I stream something or not. Okay. I wonder if any of these high scores on the table, or this table, okay, are mine, or if I just did that poorly on the charity stream. Well, there we go. Oh. Need to try launching it softer so that way it actually hits those bites. Apparently it's just impossible to get anything except that rightmost light when launching, because I don't know. Maybe I still did too hard. Weird playing pinball upside down. That's a cool ass gimmick. Playing fucking pinball upside down, where the ball's going up on the table instead of, like, where the flippers are on the top side instead of the bottom. That's. My only complaint is that the cap in here is, like, way too small. And once it's in here, as long as you're, like, flipping. Captured? What the fuck? Is that how you get multi-ball? Oh, well, that was fast. Succeeded? Okay. I have no idea how to succeed or fail getting into, out of there. Let's try. Hey, there we go! Score already. Was not paying attention, so of course I ate it. I'm just gonna say right now, with how this board works, I managed to get a score of 99 of a million. I'm done for the night. I'm not going to play the entire table again. I managed to get a score of a million. I doubt that'll happen. Yeah, I have no idea how I succeed or fail in the black hole. Gotta get enough bonus points. That would make sense. Whoa, that was extremely lucky. Another captive ball. It's not a, It's not a mirror, it's an actual lower level in the table. See, look. Ooh, whoa! Oh, that's where my multi-ball is, and then, okay. Ooh. I'm doing extremely well this life, and of course now that I said that, I'm probably going to fuck it all up. Oh, you can get over 1,000,000 points in this table. Okay. Well, guys, looks like I'm stuck for the whole hour, regardless. Oh, no! Wonder how they parse over 1,000,000, wonder how they space over 1,000,000 points when there's only... Maybe there's a little light, an extra light. But yeah, that last life lasted a long time. No, I've tilted the wrong way. I'm sorry that you're running Chalice Dungeons. I honestly have no inclination to platinum that game once I learned that Chalice Dungeons were required to platinum it. Oh boy. Woo! Chalice Dungeons are some stinkers, let me tell you. It's not even that they're bad, it's just that they're boring. No, I tilted the wrong way again. Like, the Chalice Dungeons has some cool bosses in it from what I've seen. It's just that in order to get to those cool bosses, you have to fight boss that is just normal pig. And, well... Palantir, you missed me spending, getting that current high score down there, like, more than half of that, score. I'd say, like, a good 5/7 of it, actually, was on the last life. That last life was just ridiculous. But aside from that, you haven't really missed anything. This is pinball. You don't really miss much with pinball. Most you can miss is like, oh man, I did a good. Whoa! I'm not being very entertaining. I'm concentrating. This is what happens when I stream. This is what happens when I stream alone. I just start concentrating really hard and don't talk to anybody. Don't pay attention to the chat. You can definitely see this in when I was streaming Darksiders, and there were And there's just, like, definitely one section where I just stop talking for a full, like, I don't know, 15 minutes to concentrate on what I'm doing. Hey, this was the same situation I was in when I got the high score, and I ended up doing amazingly well until I hit the multi-ball. Oh, until I got the multi-ball and just dropped the ball because I had no idea what multi-ball was like in this table yet. So that's the thing about multi-ball in pinball: if you don't know what's coming, you can like lose it really quickly. One of the best things to learn really early in a pinball table is how that particular table deals with its multi-ball. And now that I know how this table deals with multi-ball, I will not be taken quite as off guard. That was some video game physics right there. I don't think that would have happened. Three pinball games are good. This game, Arcade Pinball, actually comes with 4 free tables. This is actually one of the free tables that I'm playing right now. You get this cool Arabian Nights themed table with the genie in it. And a couple others. I forget. I don't think I've played the other two. And also, you can buy tables individually. So, if you see a cool table, that was fast. If you see a cool table that you want, then you can buy the table individually. It's like the tables themselves are pretty expensive, though. Like, I'd honestly just buy an entire season because it's like, it's like a value of 6 tables, but you get like 10 or 11 tables in it per season. Also, Pinball Arcade is really good because, with a few hiccups from just basically being a video game, this is the closest I have no idea what caused the re-entry attempt. But, that's original launch, so maybe it's just the Arabian Tales one. Yeah, maybe it's not that you got four tables for free, maybe it's that you got one for free, and then the other three were available at launch. I could have sworn that you got all four of them for free, but then again, I pretty much bought every table that's available on the PlayStation 4, because there are a couple that are available on PC right now, because Season 6 is going on strong, but for some reason Season 6 isn't on PlayStation 4. Which is a shame, because it has two Doctor Who tables on it, and I want to try those. I'm a big, stupid Doctor Who dork. Likes the show, except for when Moffat's writing it. Yeah, see, I did much worse that time, but I managed to get re-entry. Damn it. Now that I've played this table for a while, I actually really do like it a lot. It's a cool table. Woo! No! Except when it does stuff like that, oh no! The only thing I don't like about it is that, that you can't switch. Oh, goddamn! Wow, okay. Damn it! Yeah, I can't. I still have no idea how you get re-entries. I thought it was just by scoring a certain amount in there, but no, I think you have to do something specific, and I have no idea what it is. No, it's not something specific, because I see the way that the arrow's pointing right now, and that's definitely, like, I have no idea what I did. I did it. It's letting me go through. Maybe it's just gotta spend a certain amount of time in here, or it'll. You want my suggestions for individual tables? Oh, god damn it. The Star Trek Next Generation table is really good. Attack on Mars is brilliant, and I actually think somewhat of a satire on pinball, because, like, I haven't. Like, if you scored less than a billion points on Attack on Mars, that's a low score. And you should feel ashamed for yourself, because, like, just launching the ball sometimes gets you, like, 2 million points. definitely don't get Adam's Family. Dear God, do not get Adam's Family. The Terminator 2 table's really good. Here. Black Knight's actually pretty good, but, let me see. I'm looking at their stuff right now. I think it's from Medieval Madness? Yeah, Medieval Madness is really good. Honestly, Season 1 is pretty strong in general. Medieval Madness, Attack on Mars, Star Trek Next Generation. Scared Stiff is an okay board. Creature from the Black Lagoon has some pretty cool gimmicks to it. Monster Bash is pretty fun. So Season 1 in general is pretty strong. Season 3 is kind of weak, but only because that's when they started going with less boards. Not a lot in Season 2 that I've played that I like, aside from the T2 board. Season 3, Dracula is pretty good, Black Knight's pretty good. I haven't played really anything else in there. Fish Tales looked fun, but I've only seen other people play it. Season 4 Cyclone, the one I was playing last night, surprisingly good, even if it's got a creepy clown staring at you the entire time. Xenon's a fucking, like, famous board in general. The Judge Dredd table seems pretty cool. So, but my top three boards all, like, my top three boards of this game all come from Season 1. So, Attack on Mars, Star Trek, and Medieval Madness. Those are, if you had to buy any three tables, I would suggest those three. And if you had enough money to squeeze out a fourth one, T2. Which is in Season 3, I believe. 2 or 3. But part of the reason why I'm doing these pinball nights is because I own like 70 boards for this game, and I've played maybe like 10 or 11 of them, and just have not moved away from those. And then I stopped playing pinball for a really long time, and now it's like I only play three boards. So I started pinball night as a way to like just get my money's worth out of these seasons. So I just like. I really love pinball. Pinball's so fun. When you say Archer, do you mean like the fucking cartoon Archer? Like fucking Danger Zone, Pam, Lara, why? That Archer? Yep, oh god. I kind of want to play it, Lana, whatever. I haven't watched the show in, like, 3 years or something like that. Like, I got, like, halfway through their first Vice season, where they stopped being an international spy thing and started being a drug cartel. And it was like, I think it got a lot less charm once it stopped being about, like, incompetent spies and started being about incompetent, drug lords.
Attempt to pass failed.
My favorite running gag on that entire show was, Archer's, answering messages, and the one time he called his mom, and he's like, I swear to God, this isn't this isn't one of my answering machine pranks. I don't even know how I would set it up to do an outgoing phone call unless I put it, like, on a messenger or something, but, actually that could work. Anyway. I think that was the last time they did it, too. At least the last time I know about it. It's like I said, I haven't watched it since about halfway through the Vice season. Doing really bad all of a sudden. Had to talk about what tables were my favorite, and all of a sudden it's just like, well, hope you didn't like all that competence that you've built up on this table, because it's going away now. Like, see, look at that! I got over 5,000 points in the thing, and it still kicked me out into the death zone. I have no idea how you're supposed to survive in that. That's the best way to build up points, so... And unfortunately, I don't think they have, like, the rights from whatever companies they can get on, they have for these tables is to use any of the Star Wars ones. I don't think any of the people they have the permission to use tables from made a Star Wars table, which sucks, because I love a Star Wars table! There was at least one good, really, really good Star Wars table that, I don't quite remember. I remember it being good when I was a kid, but that's also because, like, I thought Star Wars could do no wrong. Keep in mind, this was before Jar Jar Binks.
Captured.
What? How is it taking place during the 40s? What the fuck? They just, like, exhaust all their Vice stuff and started just doing random shit every season? The time travel? I'm not gonna be watching the show, and if I do watch the show, I'll probably forget. That's the thing about spoiling me about stuff. Is that if I don't really care about the stuff, the spoilers will just leak out of my brain, and if I'm interested in it, then I'll just not remember it until it's too late, which is good. Just go ahead and spoil it, I don't care. Well, actually, no, don't spoil it, because if somebody's watching this when I put it on YouTube, then, and it's spoiled, then they might get really mad. See, I might be kind of lackluster on spoiler policies, but, like, look at that? I did almost nothing there, and I managed to get back into the re-entry stuff. I think my overall favorite episode of Archer was the episode where Archer's mom killed like the Russian ambassador or whatever, and tricked them into thinking that like he had a heart attack or whatever, or it's just like really kinky sex, and then they helped her dispose the body, and not even realizing it until it was too late. That was a good episode. Also, a good episode is the episode where What's-His-Face introduces a virus that has a singing pirate on all the computers. For a little while, that was my ringtone. A good episode. That's a real good episode. I don't remember. There's also an episode where Archer and Lana had to go into like the bayou or something, and And Archer is explaining like his biggest—I forget what his third biggest fear is. His first biggest fear is alligators, and his second biggest fear is crocodiles. And it's like, oh, okay. I mean, this makes sense about everything I know about Archer. Sure. Get it right, you can just keep going in here. Thank you. don't remember that one. I don't remember that one. Oh, that sounds good, though. I think I might remember that. Yes, I remember that one. I remember that one now. Oh, that was a good one, too. Also a good one, the one where, like, the Russian ambassador's, like, 14-year-old daughter keeps hitting on Archer, and he's like, no, that's creepy, stop it. It's nice to know that Archer, despite being a horn dog, still has standards about age of consent and his ideas about how Russians sort of handle age of consent, which is not very well. Oh, here we go. Maybe now deal with it just doesn't let me. Okay. Oh, that's a high score? Okay. Okay. actually have enough time for a couple more games, unless I go for one particularly long one. So either one really long game or a couple normal length games, then I'm done for the night. Almost been an hour. So overall thoughts: I really like this board. It's fun. The only sucky thing is I can't control when the multiplier lights go. But considering it only goes up to times 5, kind of makes sense. And it's also really confusing about when I get I lost my train of thought there. Unfortunately, there's no Dalek in here. Actually, I guess that would be the old school original Cybermen, which, oh my god, have you seen, the Cybermen's first iterations? The Daleks haven't changed much over the years. At least not, your basic Daleks. But, man, the Cybermen, holy shit! Originally, they just had sacks on their heads! Oh, I see how you get most of the multiplier. You're supposed to go down there and... Okay. I couldn't read those words for the longest time because my eyesight is terrible. I know how you're supposed to advance the multiplier. I can understand why they don't just let you switch the lights. That's okay. That's okay with me. I think I had time for one more game. Aww. There we go. Ooh. Whoa, what was that about? Keep going in there, okay. Yep, just keep going. Don't give a fuck! Keep going in there, it doesn't matter! Who cares? Okay, one more for the road! Let's do it! Keep advancing that multiplier, even though it's already at literally as high as it goes. It doesn't matter. It doesn't fucking matter. Great. Okay, let's do it again. Sure. Why not? Who gives a shit? Let's just spend the rest of our lives in the inside of this pinball table. Let's do it. Not like I have anything better to do tomorrow morning. Sleep is for the weak. Work is evil. Down with communism. Or down with capitalism. Let's turn the world into one big capitalist leftist utopia, please. I would love that. I would legit love that. That's my dream, actually. I think that was a video game. No, it was an arcade game. It was an arcade game. I know it definitely isn't a pinball table, because if it was a pinball table, I would be all over that shit. You could not stop me from finding an actual table of that and buying it. Yep, we're just living in here again. Fine with me, I guess.
G-Force
Nope, that's it. I think I'm done. I kicked myself off the high school board. Yep. Anyway, that's Black Hole. Pretty good table. Definitely would not recommend it over the other three I recommended earlier. But, pretty good. Later.